To Heroes Kids. So glad you have joined us for another exciting episode. Can you see what I've got here? So today in the story we're talking about a Roman soldier. What do you think these animals is all about? And what does that have to do with the Holy Spirit? Well, watch the lesson and find out. See you later.
Oh, How are you? I hope you're enjoying your everything. Last week we were talking about the Holy Spirit brings truth, and the week before it was about symbols. Well, this week it is about the Holy Spirit again interceding. So in the and there's a scripture that says, in the same way also the Spirit also helps our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought or we should, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. He searches the hearts. He knows the mind of the Spirit, what the mind of the Spirit is, and he intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. Holy Spirit, he's the helper. He's the intercessor, counselor, consoler, comforter, and advocate. It's just like as if I gave something to Miss Rose and asked her to go and do something for me, and she went and did it and she brought it back. It's like the Holy Spirit goes to the Father when you pray, and he brings it back according to the will of God. It's like a magnifying glass. He can just search it out, and he knows the truth, and he knows how to intercede, and he knows the will of God, and he can do it for us. And an intercessor is like I said, if you were at church and you needed to go down the front, but you couldn't, it was too far away. So there's a person in the middle, Miss Rose was in the middle. So you asked Miss Rose and she took it down the front and then she brought it back to you. It's like the Holy Spirit intercedes for you, goes to the Father and brings out your prayer in according to the will of God. And he comforts you, and he pleads for you, and he is a consoler, and he is an advocate. He'll stand in there for you. He'll be your aid, your support. And this is what happens when we pray in the Spirit. Holy Spirit is so wonderful. He is everything. And I'm going to tell you a story today about a Roman centurion, and his name was Cornelius. Cornelius was a centurion. Centurion means that he was a captain of 100 men. And Cornelius was there, and he had an angel, he had a vision, that is, he saw something like a dream when he was awake. And it was an angel came to see him. An angel came to see Cornelius. And he said, Cornelius, you have been such a devout man. You have loved God and you have loved the Jewish people. You have given them lots of things. And he had given them lots and lots of money and helped the poor people and anyone who had need. He was doing lots of wonderful good deeds for people. That's what Cornelius was doing. And it came up to God. It had come up to God as a memorial. God knew how good he was to his people. And he wanted to help him, so he was sending his Holy Spirit. And he said, Cornelius, go and send some of your men to Joppa. In Joppa, it's a city by the sea, there is a man called Peter, sometimes called Simon. Send your men there and get him to come back here and talk to you. Cornelius's men were coming to Joppa, and while they were doing that, Peter was in an upstairs room in his house, and he was praying, and he became hungry. And while he was waiting for the food to be cooked, prepared, he had a vision, a trance. That's like he was awake again, but he could still see. And what he saw was this huge big sheet come down out of heaven and four corners. And in the sheet was all these animals, all sorts of animals, creeping things and four-legged animals and birds, all the animals that a lot of animals they weren't allowed to eat, the Jews, they were only allowed to eat clean animals, the ones, like they weren't allowed to eat pork or prawns or anything like that, they were considered to be unclean. And this was coming down from heaven. And Peter heard a voice that say, Peter, rise up, kill and eat. And he said, no, by no means. I cannot do that. I have never eaten anything unclean. And then he heard it again. Peter, rise up, take some food, kill it and eat it. Peter said, "No, I have never eaten anything unclean." And a voice from heaven said to him, "Do not call anything unclean or unholy that I have made clean." And this happened three times. Peter said, "No, I will not eat anything unclean." And the voice said from heaven, "Do not call anything unclean that I have made clean. Do not call anything unholy that I have made clean." And God was saying that these things were clean, that Peter could eat of them. And Peter was thinking, he was scratching his head. He started to think, "What is happening? I don't understand this." And then, knock, knock, knock on the door. There were some people there. And Peter heard the Holy Spirit say to him, "Do not be have misgivings or anything like that, but I want you to go with these men. It is okay." So the men came in, Peter came down, and he said to the men, "Yes?" And they said, "We have been sent here by Cornelius. He had a vision from an angel who said to him to come and to get to you and bring you to him." Cornelius is a very devout man. He loved God, the God of the Jews, and he helped the Jewish people. And yet he was considered unclean because he was a Gentile. But Peter had just had that vision, that trance. He was in the trance where God said, "Do not call anything unclean that I have made clean." So Peter said, "Come in, come in." So the next day, after they'd had a good sleep, they got up and they walked along and they came up to Cornelius. Cornelius was in a city called Caesarea. And when he got there, he came to Cornelius and he said, and Cornelius bowed down to him. And Peter said, "No, don't do that. I am just a man, just like you are." He said, "Why, Cornelius, have you called me to you?" And Cornelius said, "About 4 days ago, I had a vision from an angel who came and asked me to get you to come and talk to me." And Peter said, "I have been shown that we are all the same, that there is no one who is unclean. God has no partiality or favor towards anybody, but we are all one." And so Peter started to tell everybody. He had, Cornelius had arranged, asked all his family and his friends to come, and there was quite a big crowd of people there. And Peter said to them all about Jesus. He told them all about Jesus, how Jesus had been born and how he had lived and he had died for our sins so that we could be forgiven of our sin. And Peter told all these people, all these Gentile people, all about it. And while he was talking to them, he said to them, "Whoever has a heart to run after God, whoever believes in God, whose heart wants to follow God, they are accepted in God's sight." And then, as he was speaking, because the people were believing him, the gift of the Holy Spirit was coming down on them. And they started speaking in other tongues and glorifying God and exalting God. And it was a wonderful, beautiful time. And Peter said to his friends, because he brought his friends, some friends with him, who were Jewish friends, just like him. And he said, "If these Gentile people have been baptized in the Holy Spirit, they have the Holy Spirit in them, speaking in tongues, why can they not be baptized in water?" So they were baptized in water by full immersion. They went right into the water, totally covered, and came back out like a water baptism lesson, where they died to their old life and came up to live a total new life in Jesus. So this is what happened as well. So they were fully whelmed and fully baptized in water, and then they were fully whelmed and fully baptized with the Holy Spirit, and they were speaking in tongues, and the Holy Spirit was bringing about his will through their prayers. That is what the Holy Spirit does. He is an helper, an intercessor, an advocate, a consoler. He fights for us. He comforts us when we're in affliction, and makes things a place of ease and pleasant. And he was an advocate for Peter. Peter was that he used Peter as an advocate for the Holy Spirit towards Cornelius when he taught Cornelius how all about Jesus and the truth, and how Holy Spirit told Peter that it's okay that the Gentiles were no longer unclean through the Holy Spirit, that they were able to receive the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was working there, bringing them together. What a wonderful thing. What a wonderful thing. And you know what? You can have that too. You can have that same beautiful prayer thing in your life. You, if you believe with all your heart and you want to follow God, you can pray and ask the Holy Spirit to fill you. And you can speak in other languages and other tongues as well. And then the will of God is in your life. When you pray, the will of God comes into your life through the gift of the Holy Spirit. Isn't that just so wonderful? Let's pray. Father, we just thank you that you are our Lord and our Savior and our Master and our everything, Lord, and that you reveal everything to us, Lord, that you care so much for us. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Hello again. So our lesson is about interceding, and our memory verse is Romans 8:27b. The Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. So our lesson is about interceding, and interceding is the Holy Spirit going to the Father for us to let things happen in our life that we need, that are according to the will of God. It's like as if we were in church and you're at the back and there's all these chairs there and you need something down the front, and Miss Rose is down the front, and you yell out, "Miss Rose, can you help me please?" And she comes and she gives you what you need. That's what the Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit intercedes like that for us with anything at all that you have on your heart, that you're concerned about or you're happy about, anything at all in your life. The Holy Spirit will intercede for you before God. Isn't that wonderful?